الحمد لله رب العالمين، الحمد لله ذي الملك والملكوت ذي العزة والجبروت، الحمد لله حي قيوم لا ينام، عزيز لا يضام، قهار لا يرام، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما. أما بعد، يقول الباري سبحانه وتعالى بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. Who you believe, fear Allah as he should be feared, and die not except on the state of Islam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most merciful, grant us this great gift to die on the state of Islam. Allahumma ameen, ya rabbal alameen. Amma ba'd. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide his servant to the best of the good and to the greatest of the reward. And in the spirit of the khutab that we are sharing with you, the idea or the intention is to really kind of correct some of the understanding of the meaning that we have, to dust them off from a lot of cultures and a lot of habit, to bring it to the way that it may our engine you really for the action, to remove desensitization, to be from those who race for the good. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he talk about and praise such a people, he gave them in names, and one of the names that he gave them is ulul albab, ulul nuha, the people with understanding, with the people with the mind, the people who conceive, the people who reflect. Therefore, he made the fact of a ta'aql, of conceiving, of perceiving, of comprehending, of understanding, is a level of those who are being praised, and those who truly can understand the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and those who can live under the shade of the or the shades of the guidance of the ultimate truth, which is the truth of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in this ayah from Surah Az-Zumar, قَالَ وَالَّذِينَ جَتَنَبُوا الطَّاغُوتَ أَن يَعْبُدُوهَا وَأَنَابُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ لَهُمُ الْبُشْرَى فَبَشِّرْ عِبَادِ. Those who avoid the worship of the ta'ghut, any deity worshipped other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, avoided to not worship it, قَالُوا يَجْتَنِبُوا الطَّاغُوتَ أَن يَعْبُدُوهَا وَأَنَابُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ, and they returned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in repentance, in submission. قَالَ لَهُمُ الْبُشَرُ, those people who have the glad tidings, فَبَشِّرْ عِبَادِ, addressing to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, give the glad tidings to my servant, to this type of servant. Then who are these servants? What is their characteristic? What is their qualities? قَالَ أَلَّذِينَ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقَوْلَ فَيَتَّبِعُونَ أَحْسَنَهُ. Those who listen to the speech, those who listen to the words, and they follow the best of it. We have mentioned this ayah before, and the ayah is the Quran, but today we want to take it from another perspective, from another angle, as I have mentioned in my introduction, to be what the meaning of ulul albab, because this is what Allah is going to tell in us. قَالَ أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ هَدَاهُمُ اللَّهُ, those that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have guided, وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمْ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ, those are people who are being endued with understanding, those are the people of understanding. So you see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's like praising this type of people who have the qualities of understanding, because the understanding of the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes someone to have the greatest of the gift, which is the fahm. And the fahm is in fact understanding. The fahm gives the ability to have the criterion. The criterion is to make the distinction between the good and the bad, between al-haq wal-batil, the truth and falsehood. This criterion will illuminate your path and give you the power and the ability by the will of Allah to be firm on your path and racing and going toward and traveling toward Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in safety and tranquility, seeking His pleasure. Therefore, the understanding is a key into the path of the believer. Therefore, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here in this ayah, if we try to reflect on it, look what He said, قَالَ أَلَّذِينَ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقَوْلَ فَيَتَّبِعُونَ أَحْسَنَ. Those who are listening to the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they follow the best of it. So when we think of this ayah, many of us, they go to the last part, which is they follow, and following is al-ittiba'. It is actually we are recommended and commanded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to follow the way of the guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But the key of the guidance, the key of the following, the key of the path to the pleasure of Allah started with one condition, with one quality, which is al-istima'. Al-sama' is to listen. To listen first. When someone had preconceived idea, whatever is being said to him, he already have that conclusion. So he didn't listen. Therefore, the words of Allah will not have any effect in such a people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us that the people, they have the ability to listen, but in the same time, they are deaf. قَالَ وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَسْتَمِعُونَ إِلَيْكَ بَيَّسْتَمِعُونَ إِلَيْكَ أَفَأَنْتَ تُصْمِعُ الصُّمَّ وَلَوْ كَانُوا لَا يَعْقِلُونَ. And among them, they are listening to you. Are you trying to make the deaf to hear? Which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us these people are deaf. They cannot listen. Therefore, the listening, that it helped the believer to be raised to the rank of the people of understanding, so he will know how to follow the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how to follow the guidance, how to find the path to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how to travel steadily and firmly in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He has to start with this meaning of the istima'. When you listen to the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's not about to have tears because of the beautiful voice you are listening. Is about the deep meaning that need to change your heart, need to change your action. When we saying such a thing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as you mentioned, is not whatever have someone who listening, he going to be guided. No. There is something inside the nafs. There is something inside the nafs that it need to have, subhanAllah, that effect of the word that being heard. If that inside the nafs is not affected, it does not have any effect, or it does not change, does not react, then we are deaf. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. And if you go in further analysis, we'll find like anything that you hear, you react to it if it has mustaqar in the nafs. What is the mustaqar? It have an abode in the nafs, something that is going to subhanAllah, kind of land in, onto it in the nafs. If someone, for example, he truly loves money, when he hears money, he's like, he's attentive. He want to talk, he want to share, he want to get into the discussion, even people they don't know. He can give some tips. Why? Because this in his nafs, that word landed there somewhere in this nafs. When we talk about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if someone does not have the meaning of who is Allah, or he does not have that such great veneration and glorification to Allah, when the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is heard, it does not have anything in his nafs to land on it, so he will make that effect of glory. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about the believer, قال, وَإِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ. When Allah's name mentioned, just the name of Allah mentioned, their soul is filled with fear. Their heart is filled with fear. As when we come to the disbeliever, I will not say disbeliever, the people who do not believe in the hereafter, which is meaning they are not really caring or mindful about standing before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala what He said in Surah Az-Zumar. قال وإذا ذكر الله وحده اشمأزت قلوب الذين لا يؤمنون بالآخرة. When Allah alone is mentioned, the heart of those who do not believe in Allah is filled with disgust. Why? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He didn't say disbelieve, He said do not believe in the hereafter. might be a Muslim, but he's not really mindful of meeting Allah. Therefore, the understanding of the meaning of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for such people is everything is haram. All what they want in this life, from good lifestyle that they believe it's good, it is forbidden in the deen. Therefore, when they are intending to do something, is going to really shear their hearts, but they know it's haram. When someone addressed them, said, remember Allah, they hate that remembrance. Why? Because those words lands on something sick in their nafs. And here is already, subhanAllah, someone he's like, he has kind of a covering on his ears and on his heart. Therefore, whatever Quran will be recited, whatever reminder will be addressed to such people, they will not have any effect. They will not be reminded. They will not be admonished. Why? Because that receiver, which is going to receive these words, is dead, is deaf, is absent, is heedless. And these are the elements that make someone, subhanAllah, way of listening, way of, subhanAllah, reacting to the reminder of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, is like absent, dormant, is not there at all. Dear brother, respected sisters, we are in need to know ourselves first so we know how we can correct it. We listen to the Quran, we read the Quran, and not only the Quran, the guidance, the teaching of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the advices, the some subhanallah reminders of people who have knowledge, but it's not changing us. And this is one of the elements that really make a defect into the system of the reception, which is that subhanAllah understanding or what knowledge we have of Allah, what knowledge we have and closeness we have, the relation with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. People who do not have veneration and respect to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when his name is mentioned, they really, you feel something, they will even say evil words. In a way, can you please change the subject? Why? Like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about the hypocrite in Medina, they lived with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قَالْ وَمِنْهُمُ الَّذِينَ يُؤْذُونَ النَّبِيِّ يَقُولُونَ هُوَ أُذُنْ. And it comes also to the listening. And among them, they're really hurting and bothering the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by saying, he's an ear. So he listened to everything. قَالْ قُلْ أُذُنُ خَيْرٌ. Allah is defending his Prophet. He said he's listening, but he's listening for good, for your good. Because if a hypocrite comes to the Prophet ﷺ and said, Ya Rasulullah, I have excuses, Ya Allah, forgive me. And then when he went, he said, I already told him, and he believed me. The Prophet ﷺ, he knows that that person is a liar. But the Prophet, he will not uncover that person. He make dua for him, because when he might Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide him, he will not have been uncovered, so he will have difficulty to come back to Allah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala قال هو أذن خير لكم يؤمن بالله ويؤمن للمؤمنين. He truly believe only the mu'min, the believers, and he is a mercy for you. However, alhamdulillah, the majority of the Muslims, they have that great respect to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but they don't have that subhanallah engine who help them to change themselves. His guidance is not changing them. Why? This is the second element who have our system of listening who has a defect. The system which is saying there is, subhanAllah, kind of we've been in a prison of desires, as we have mentioned last khutbah. And the desire, as I said, is not like amusement and entertainment and play. The inner desire, the hour instant, all your income that you're looking forward, your family, your children, your business, your studies, all of that. But when we have, subhanAllah, we encircled ourselves with fear. Fear to not have enough income, fear to fail, fear to not achieve what I have started. That fear, subhanAllah, put us in a prison. And this type of prison, it has an effect on connecting the reminder, which is the Sama'. So we listen to the way of Allah that is not changing us. Why? Because we are kind of this envelope of heedlessness. The third element, or that we can mention in this subject that it has effect on the system of listening to change us, to remind us, to act upon the teaching of the Quran, to live under the shade or the shadow of the truth, the ultimate truth of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is this desensitization, and we talked about many times about that. You hear, for example, people are dying, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala embrace them in His rahmah. The first time, someone is reminded, the second time, less reminded, the third time, subhanallah, with all the social media people, they say a lot of dead people, to the point that there's desensitization when you see dead people, may Allah forgive him. But what it had, this is a new that we heard, what we have read, but it didn't do anything in us. Why? Because this is caused by the weakness of the faith that we have, weakness of Iman. Add to it the habit, it caused the desensitization. So to be desensitized in a way that the thing that is usually help us to repent, help us to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it becomes something like anything else. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions such a thing in the Quran about the disbeliever when they were being like, you know, showing or like competing to show who the best, who the people who have the best, you know, the most noble among their tribes. When they were counting the people who are alive, they said, but we have dead people greater than yours. So they went to the graveyards to say, this one who is dead, he's one of us, this one is one of us, to the point that they said, okay, now among the ahya, among the living ones, you have Bani Abdi Auf better than Bani Sahm. But when they went to the graveyards, they said, oh, Bani Sahm, we are better than you. We have more noble people. But those noble people who, that in your mind who died, where are they now? And this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us to not have been, subhanAllah, desensitized to think about dead people or graveyard or the things that is related to the akhirah, that it does not have any effect in our heart, does not have any effect on our reminder. This is the ayah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the surah that He revealed, أَلْهَاكُمُ التَّكَاثُرُ حَتَّى زُرْتُمُ الْمَقَابِرُ. You've been diverted by the increasing in the worldly life to the point that you think when you mention about subhanAllah the dead people, not as a reminder for yourself that you're going to die tomorrow, but as a way of showing off. And ikhwani, this has a question mark. What happened to one's heart if he's really not listening? He's not trying to be from the people of the understanding. If we ask the question, where is the sickness, where is the defect? It is really in the heart. Because whatever you love, whatever you filled your heart with, that's the thing that you're going to pay attention to it. The people of Musa, alayhi salam, they were so distracted. They were traveling with Musa, they endured a lot of difficulties. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came to take a covenant from them to listen, they were very distracted. People who only think about the gift, the tangible gift. Look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most merciful, what He have done to them to raise their attentiveness to its peak. Subhanallah, He take the whole mountain to be like dark cloud on top of their heads. Did you ask why? Subhanallah, to bring their attention to listen. But subhanallah, we have the Quran. We do not need a mountain to be threatening us to fall on our heads, to destroy us or to smash us or to kill us, so we will listen. We have the reminder of the Quran. We have the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, whatever you fill your heart, so if you want to test yourself, because the whatever you have in your heart is going to turn in a willpower. That willpower that driving you in your life, what you see, what you want, is because of what you have in your heart. Then look at yourself. If what you want in your life is far from Allah, so that we know this is a sign that Allah's love is not in our hearts. We need to be frank with ourselves. When we test, See, subhanAllah, your willpower, your ambition to be a great person, to be, subhanAllah, successful in your career, that's all is good. But if it filled your heart, therefore there is no enough love of Allah in your heart. Therefore, the system of listening, to be reminded with the Quran, to be raised to the rank of Ulil Albab, it's not there. It's not there. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given us an example in the Quran and show us the magnitude of such subhanallah want when you shift it from Allah to another thing, how all your life will change. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam appointed 50 archers, as you know, in Ghazwat Uhud. When they saw subhanallah, when they saw that the disbelievers are running away, fleeing, and they saw the spoils on the battlefield. The spoils was representing the worldly life. And here, subhanAllah, the test happened. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala qala walaqad sadaqakum Allahu wa'ada. Allah fulfilled what He had promised you. You came submitting to Allah. You came invoking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for victory. He gave you the victory. But now that your heart is shifting from Allah's pleasure to looking for the dunya, look what happened to you. When you were looking at the dunya and the battlefield, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fulfilled His promise to you. You made the dua, Allah answered your dua. You went to sujood and you have tears and Allah gave you. All of you, if you take a list and write it down, you see how many times Allah, every time you ask Him, He'll give you. But when we shift our heart, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala leave you alone, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala turn away from you, you only will blame ourselves. This is the example that I'm giving here in Ghazwat Uhud with the best of those who can be in companion to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The best generation after the Prophet, as the scholar is saying, are the companion of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The heart shifted. They looked at the dunya. They look at the camels. They look, their hearts went to it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قَالَ مِنْكُمْ مَنْ يُرِيُ Among you who want the worldly life and among you who want the akhirah. Ibn Mas'ud said, قَالَ وَاللَّهِ I would never have believed that among us from the companion will be longing for the dunya. Longing from the dunya, but seeking the akhirah. Seeking the akhirah. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to show us the magnitude of a shifting of a heart. Just a little. Just. And look what happened to the companion. Look what happened to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam because of those who disobeyed him. Why? Because they listened. But when it comes to continue, because the listening, it does not end at the listening of the words. It ends as carrying these words to be an action, to be an intention, to be an emotion, to be a willpower, to be an ambition. But when they shifted, look what happened to them. Dear brother, respected sisters, it's a very important subject if you just reflect on it. If we listen to the Book of Allah, if we listen to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addressing to us within the Quran, and we don't change, the problem it's not us not changing. The problem is we are unmindful even to be intended to change. So this is an invitation, starting with myself and all my dear brother, respected sisters, to think why the Quran is not affecting me. When the companion Ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim, they were in Mecca, they were persecuted, they were weak, they were poor, they were under persecution. But subhanAllah, when they read the Quran, they find vast horizon. They find great ambition. They read the Quran. They love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, their teacher. They know that he's saying the truth. They hear to the words of Allah. When they hear, faces today are, subhanAllah, glowing with light. They dream to be, have that face. We don't want to have face, people who have titles, or to have awards, or to have winning games. You see them on the TV, and people, they dream. Why they dream? They don't dream to be someone, a player, or artist, or an actor. They dream because they see how beautiful it is to be joyful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows ourselves. He gave you the, subhanAllah, the image of those who are glowing faces, joyful. قال وجوه يومئذ ناظرة إلى ربها ناظرة وجوه يومئذ مستبشرة ضاحكة مصفرة ضاحكة مستبشرة. Imagine, have this image in front of you. If you listen with your heart, if you listen with your mind, if you listen with your soul, this is, subhanAllah, it becomes an image, a true image in front of you. This is, becomes your ambition. That's how the companion then changed. Because they listened to the Quran and it turned into true reality. And whoever who live under this great reality, the trials becomes for him a joy and a gift. The trials becomes for him purification. The worship changed to him not as a burden. It's going to be the element, the tools who give him that tranquility. But may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala correct our system of listening to be from these ulil albab. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروا الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على النبي المصطفى أما بعد. Dear brother, respected sisters, being from ulil albab, the people of understanding, is not something to read on the Quran and to think this is only reserved for those rooted in knowledge. You are already from the people of understanding. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow on you the gift of being a believer, of being one who submit to Allah. But we have some work to do. From among the companions, Ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim, who lived such reality, who lived the ultimate truth, Bilal radiallahu anhu. Bilal being servant and slave to Umayyah, turning to be slave to Allah. Bilal, whose body under the control of Umayyah, and being persecuted by when he has the ambition and he see the image of the Quran as true as what he's touching, his heart start to be chanting, Ahadun Ahad. Ahadun Ahad, Allah one, Allah one. They add his persecution and his iman is getting stronger and stronger. Why? Because he listened. He loved the Prophet. He loved Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Quran becomes a reality. He sees these glowing faces standing in the Day of Judgment. He sees them looking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It became an ambition that it really make his soul to all be shining with the light, with the shining, with the joy. Therefore, what persecution will change him? What persecution or punishment will have even have any effect on the body of Bilal? A man who will have his freedom, not by just being liberated, to have the change the title from a slave to a free man. No, he had already his freedom because he liberated his soul. He liberated his heart. And by liberating his heart, he started to understand and comprehend the words of Allah. Bilal, when he was asked, you didn't have any pain? He said, yes, I did. But the sweetness of the iman that I have overcame the pain. I didn't feel then any pain because I was with Allah. And this is, ikhwani, the effect of the sama'. This is, if we seek in everyone to be from the people of the understanding, he know the route. Go to your heart. And if you check your heart, if you want to see what do you have in your heart, look at your ambitions. If your ambition is still is little small things, then your heart is empty. Go back to your heart. Feel it with Allah. Feel it with the Quran. Feel it with these images, true images. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling you about glowing faces, not someone who gets a great title or award. Glowing faces because you are in the Day of Judgment. Because you've been with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this life. يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِيهِ وَأُمِّهِ وَأَبِيهِ وَصَاحِبَتِهِ وَبَنِيهِ. The day that someone will be fleeing from his brother, from his mother, from his father, from his children, from his spouse. And you will have one thing. When one look at your face, you know how you've been living in your life. That glowing face that today people they have because they have extra bucks, or because they won a great award, or they've been mentioned in the first page of magazine, or they've been famous. This is all is going to end in a moment. That this glowing face that you come to it when you correct your system of listening, that is must be the ambition of every believer. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala illuminate our heart with His love. Allahumma bestow on us your love and the love of your Prophet and your love of everything that it leads us to your love. Allahumma make us from those who have been reminding you from al-dhakirina kathira wa dhakirat. Allahumma ighfir lana dhunubana ajma'in wa tub alayna innaka anta at-tawwabur rahim. Allahumma ati nufusana taqwaha wa zakkiha anta khayru man zakkaha. أنت وليها ومولاها ربنا اغفر لنا ذنوبنا أجمعين فإنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين وأقم الصلاة يرحمكم الله